I'll quickly walk you through how I do a quick analysis on Dow Jones in 5 steps. The code demo will include getting web data, creating data table, defining target, defining triggering event, and printing result. Before we move on, make sure you have installed Python and have the virtual environment ready. If you haven't done so, you may check out the setup process below in the description. Let's begin. Remember, our first step is to get the stock data from web. So in case you're not using Visual Studio Code, you can use the Python IDLE, which is this one. Let me show you. CMD. Go to IDLE by doing this. So in my case, it's in my D drive Python folder. It may be different on your side, but I'm just showing you the machine that I'm working on. So it's Python Anaconda 3. You will always see Anaconda 3, but not necessarily this part, Python, because you may have your own username. Anaconda 3, and I have an environment, so it's inside my ENVS folder, and my environment is my tray. And then you simply go to your python-m idle-lib.idle. Click enter. In this part, you don't need to create a new file. You can just use the interactive prompt. In this case, I'm going to get Dow Jones, DJI, the Dow Jones data from Yahoo Finance. And we need import pandas data reader dot data. So I need the pandas data reader. Again, if you haven't gotten the package, you can follow this video to install this pandas data reader to your environment. Hopefully no error message. It's good to go. And then we need the datetime package as well. Usually the datetime package is already installed when you install pandas. Okay, so and let me define the start day. The start day is utilizing the datetime package, datetime method. And I'm going to get from 1985, January 29th. And the end day is today. Date time dot today. The stock that I'm going to get is Dow Jones. Oops. Excuse me. In case if you don't remember the stock code, simply go to any browser. Type the stock that you're looking for. In my case, it's Dow Jones. And then just type Yahoo Finance. And then you will see, just look for this part. It is the stock code. Okay, so once you get the stock code, enter. And then you store it inside a data frame, which is a table. Table df equals web. The web is coming from pandas data reader. So it's just this web. We are utilizing this library. Dot, we're using the method called data reader. And it's getting the stock, which is defined here, DJI. And the method that we are getting data is Yahoo Finance. So we just put Yahoo inside the single quote. We are starting from the start day and the end day. So hopefully, yep, it works. Usually I will print out the first 5 rows to see we get. So we get some data here, right? So we only use the adjusted close column instead of this close. So basically what I do is df equals df dot rename. I just rename with the columns equal this sign. It is a tuple. Okay, the tuple, dictionary, whatever. I just remember that. This is grammar. And I just put single quote, colon, single quote. Oops. Just rename the adjusted close to small letter. Close instead of capital letter close. So this one. So when you print out the first five rows, you will see this close, new close, in comparing to this big close. And again, I only want several columns. So I only want df equals df.log. And then you have a square bracket. It is an array. An array is the whole thing of the table. So the first part, I separate two parts. The two parts are the row and columns. Should be rows. Okay. And since we want all rows, we put a colon to indicate all rows. We are getting from day one, 1985, all the way to 2018, March 2nd. And the columns that we are going to include is also inside another square bracket. And they are separate from a single quote for a column head. I want open, high, low, and the small letter close. Note that I exclude this column, and I also want volume. So when you print out df again, this time I'm going to print out the latest five rows, enter, you will see this open, high, low, small letter close, and volume. Okay, so once you make sure you get all the data that you want, you save it to your local drive. Some people use the other coding method for lifetime feeding, but I'm not going to do this at this moment because it may mess things up. So I'll just follow the most fundamental way. So I'm going to save it to somewhere in my drive. So I just call it a data source, and it's going to be equal to, I put an R and in a single quote, and then put your path here. Okay, so it's going to be in D drive. I just called it a dji.xl. Enter. I can use pd, excuse me. Did I import pandas? No, I didn't. So import pandas as pd. And then I'm going to save my table df to the location here, data source. So I simply do df.to_excel because I'm going to save it to an Excel file. If you want to save it to CSV, then you do to CSV. But in my case, I just do to Excel. Where should I save? I save it to data source. So just enter. Hopefully it works. Yep, it should work. Let me go to my D drive. Toot folder. DJI here. Let me check. So it's starting from 1985 all the way down to this moment, March 2nd. Let's take a break first. For step two, we can start coding. Go to command prompt first. Oops. Okay, so we go back to the command prompt. So this time we need to create a new file. So just press, okay, I'd rather not use the shortcut. Just Control N, new file. And let me save that first. You can go to file, Control S. I just save this one as tutorial demo as a Python file. Okay, so you save it. Before I go deep, let me recap what steps we have. We just finished off step one, which is getting web data. In our case, it's a Dow Jones index. Step two, I'm going to store the web data in a tabular format. So for me, format, okay? So this is step two. Let me do it first. So for step three, four, and five. Step three, we need to define our target, which is in this case, we want to know the daily percentage change N days after. For step 4, it's going to be the criteria to get to the target. And step 5 is rather easy, only printing the result. The very first thing to do is to import pandas as PD because we need the pandas library for data processing. And we also want NumPy, and I also need datetime library because in step 4, I will be creating something called D criteria, day criteria. So that's why we need the datetime as DT. Once we import all the libraries that we need, we can create a table to read the data that we get from step 1. Call this table DF. You can name this as whatever table name. So it's totally up to you. DF stands for data frame, and I just use DF by convention. I'm going to use the pandas library, which you see here, PD. It stands for pandas. I'm going to use the method of read Excel because from previous step, I stored the file to D drive, and I forgot to show you because I need to define where I store the file. Actually, the data source is what you did in step 1. For simplicity, I just read a file from my source that I defined before. It should be dji.excel. In IDLE, you will have a list that pops up. So basically, we just read data source. Sometimes you may see people do that, just write a long path here. I don't really like that because usually you will refer to the file path later. So I simply define that ahead. So I put data source. You see me jumping back and forth because I want to see something ahead. So let me just print df.tail, the latest 5 days, just to see what we have. And then I press F5, save, and then run the file. So it depends on what text editor you use. In IDLE, you can simply click this, run, or just F5. Okay, so it's okay to save. Let me see what we have. Okay, because we are reading from the Excel file. That's why we have a whole bunch of columns, including the date, open, hello, close. What you see here, the leftmost column, these are the sequence that describes the rows. It's the 8341st row of the data. This is called index because we use the index to look up for the value in the columns. It's just Excel. Like if you use Excel before, then you know what I mean. In this case, I want date to be the leftmost column because we can refer to the low in whatever day or the high in whatever day instead of going like 8339th row of the high column. So we can simply go back to our step 2, put a comma, and then just add index underscore col, which stands for column, that equals to whatever column that you want to be your index. I want it to be the date. So just put date, and then I run again by pressing run or F5. After I press run, the date column to be the index. So that next time, let's say if I want to know the volume on March 1st. So what can I do? Print df, and then you remember the dot look thing. I just put the row and a column. The row is going to be March 1st. So I just put 2018 March 1st. That string has to be exactly the same as this one because it is underneath the index column as a label. And for columns, which column am I looking for? Which is the volume. So let's press F5 to run. Then I will have this one, 50628, which is exactly the same as this one. So this is one of the way that you look for the particular value. And now I can move on. So basically what we are looking for in step 3 is the percentage change of the close price n days after. So I just define that as n day forward. You can have whatever name that you want. And I just put 2 days. I need to create a column of daily percentage change based on the close date. I mean the close price. So I just create new column. By doing this, I just add df, which is the table, followed by a square bracket. I just put single quote and then I add a new name inside. Usually I just name day underscore chg for daily change. And the daily change equals close column, this one, close column. And then we use the method called percentage change. It's going to calculate the percentage change based on the previous date. Let's say if we are calculating the day on March 1st, then it's going to be looking back from the day before, which is February 28th, and then it's going to calculate the percentage change. But we don't want it to be in decimal. So let's say 10% is going to be equal to 0.1, right? But we don't want 0.1, we want 10%, right? So we are going to do it by 0.1 times 100 to get 10%. So we are going to multiply this whole thing by 100. Actually, you don't need the bracket. The reason why I include here is just showing you graphically. I will just print out the date change to see whether my code works. This is just my habit. So just print this part includes already. So we press F5. So I have the new column. Let's say from March 1st, it's dropping 1.67% from the day before. Okay, so the close on the March 1st is 24608. I'm going to minus this one, 25029, which is the previous close day. And then I divide it by the base, which is 25022, and then times 100. So it's about negative 1.68. So it's more or less the same as this one. So I think my code is correct. We need to create another column called end day change that describes whatever number of days after today. I want to know the percentage change 2 days after. What I can do is df day change dot shift bracket. We use the dot shift method of a negative number of days. So sometimes you will see like 1, 10, whatever. But I want to develop my program further in the future. So this part is going to be input, whatever, something. And then you will see a user interface that allows you to enter the number of days. Here, I'll show you this one, end day forward. So that it's going to be looking ahead 2 days. So let's print that out in the first 5 days. And then just to see if our calculation is right. Is here, first 5 days, starting from 1985. So starting from the 31st, the day change is negative 05. 2 days later, I should get 0.96, right? Because it's jumping 1, 2. So from Feb 4th, it's going to be 0.96, and I get 0.96 here. Let's just take a break. The stock is going up 1%. And I want to know, like, 2 days later, what will happen? What will happen? I have to define a criteria. In terms of the criteria, I'm going to split the criteria into two parts. So the first one is going to be from the data. What range of data that I want to base my decision on? So it can be described in D criteria. I call it D criteria, or you can call it day criteria or whatever. It's just a name. D criteria and the trait character, which is like today is going up 1%, then it's defined in the T criteria. Again, this is just the name. I usually define the name first, and then I fill in the details. That's easier for me to grasp the gist of the idea. So let's define the criteria. Criteria is just the date, right? Because I know it's going to be whatever date range that I'm looking for. And since the date range is already included in the index, the date column, 2 days, right? The start day and the end day. And the start day is just looking up the index that is more than or equal to whatever period. That's why previously we defined the date column as the index. And it's very flexible because I can just put like it's from like 1985 February or whatever day, Jan 29th. The end day is also the index. And I use the less than or equal to because you want to include the latest date, right? And then I just put whatever day. So let's say if you're born 1997, December 31st, or simply just December. It's totally up to you. But usually I include the latest day. So that's why I use dt.datetime.today so that I don't need to change the code every day. The second part is a triggering event, T criteria first, and it's going to be simply the day change, the daily change percentage is more than 1%. Let's say if it's dropping 1%, it's just less than or equal to or whatever, -1. So what you can input -1. So we just define that for days that is less than 1%. Then 2 days later, what will happen? We go back to the table df. We have a square bracket. And here we simply include the criteria here. We just want to filter out the days that meet the criteria. So when it meets the criteria, then I want to, okay, let's just print out the latest 5 days first because it's going to be very big. So just press F5. Let's see what we get. Oh, you know what? I have typo. T criteria. D criteria. Sorry. That's why you have to pay attention to your typing. Then now we can run again. Press F5. Okay, this time it works. You just filter out the days that meet the criteria. So you see, for Feb 8th, you have the daily change that is more than dropping 1%. It's dropping 4% here. So these are all the days that match the criteria. And we can have the column of n days changed and n which is 2. So we know that 2 days after it's going to go back up 1.69%. Given that we have these long tables, then we can start compiling the stat data on this column, the n day change, such as the average, standard deviation, or whatever stat figures. In step 5, we can simply print df. Criteria. It's the table that we just did here. And we can use the dot add method, which is this one. Inside the dot add, we include an array, which is simply another table. Just think of it as another table. And then you can fill in whatever stat data that you want. Usually I want to know the mean, the average, the median, and the standard deviation. Okay, so let's press F5 and save it. So this is the part that we just get. And then we have, oh, excuse me, because I just compile all the mean, median, and standard deviation for all the columns. But this case, I don't want all that. That's why before a dot add method, you can add the dot loop method to slice whatever columns that you want to include. And again, inside the dot loop, you have row and column, right? And I want all the columns. But you can further slice it with whatever period. But I'm not going to do it here. I just want all rows of the days that match the criteria. And the columns is going to be wrapped around by the square bracket. And I just want to know the end day forward, end day change, or what you can add the close. It's not required. You can just skip that. But like in this case, just show you I can do. Okay, just run again. And now this time, I only have two columns stats data. That's the mean. I just do a very quick interpretation. It's not very scientific, but I just give you a simple idea. So that means for the mean, 0.124%. And the standard deviation is 1.86%. That means 2 days later, it can be 0.124 plus 1.86%. 1.984% at max, or 0.124 minus 1.86% going down. So it's going to be negative, 72% about. It's about like 34% chance that you reach an update of 1.984%, or 34% chance of going down 1.72% at max. I just give you a simple idea because this is not a stats course. It's about programming. So I just give you an idea on how to do it with Python. So hopefully it helps. Thank you. Bye bye.